The directive was issued by Medad Lubega Segona, the chairperson COSASE, during a meeting held between the committee and officials of Uganda Wildlife Authority, who had appeared to respond to a number of audit queries raised in the December 2023 Auditor General's report. The committee gave the Auditor General 4 months to have the forensic audit done.
Auditor General, we are also ordering a forensic in the same affairs, but to avoid duplication, the same team will work on our audit report and also give us our copy, such that as you they submit to the minister, we want our copy here as parliament. Auditor General, are we together?
Yes, we are together, Chair.
And for us, we are giving you 4 months from now.
The Auditor General noted that although Uganda Wildlife Authority reported to have collected 22.461 billion shillings as revenue from gorilla and chimpanzee tracking in 2022 and 2023, his request for data regarding financial transactions, such as records of invoices, payment, and reconciliation to the system was denied, a decision he said limits his audit work into verifying the correctness of the said earned revenue.
As a result of that action, how much have they quantified? Because you know the accounts are not like the other accounts we are used to. Here they have earned and unearned. Because when someone has booked the permits in a given financial year accounting period and does not come, how do they treat that one? If you look at page 15, Mr. Chairman,
of
not 15 years, there is unearned income.
However, Sam Mwanda, the executive director of Uganda Wildlife Authority, denied allegations of blocking auditors from accessing the system.
Because the police had labeled it a crime scene and it was under the custody of police, they needed to liaise with the police cyber team to help them access the data.
What is the status of the police investigations? Because normally, when they are carrying out investigations, there's a report they issue out.
The one on police, I know that they are still doing their investigations. As late as last week, some of our staff were called to go and make statements. We don't know how far they are.
Uganda Wildlife Authority informed the committee that fraud was discovered in August 2023 by the authority's internal audit department, and 14 staff were implicated into the fraud, and of these, 7 underwent a disciplinary process, while the other 7 staff are still facing disciplinary investigation by the authority, and the team implicated in the fraud have been denied access to the new system.
Sir, the matter is still under investigation.
Who committed fraud?
The matter is still under investigation.
Who committed fraud?
The suspects are Gade Kochu, sales executive, Grace Mubezi, senior sales executive, Bosco Mwanda, accounts clerk.
Bosco Mwanda,
accounts clerk.
Not Mwanda, but Mwanda.
Mwanda.
Confirm
completely different names.
Names, but not connected, not related.
Not related.
Not the names, but the persons are not related.
They are not related.
Okay.
Sir. Yes. Yusuf Asimire.
MPs wondered why the employees implicated in the fraud still have to remain at work.
The presenter, whereby could be there some of them who are here, because if you say that they are already on job, they need to give us a proper update of what steps have been taken to avert this from future occurrence.
Mwanda informed the MPs that the implicated staff no longer have access to the booking system.
5 were found guilty and have been either terminated or dismissed, and 2 were found not guilty.
How do you terminate somebody who you have found guilty? And then the other one you dismiss.
It depends on the gravity of the offense, sir.
We are talking about fraud.
The authority also revealed that they aren't aware of the status of the police investigations. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.